Y vamos a hablar ahora de otro tema del que todo el mundo está hablando y es la entrevista del príncipe Harry y su esposa Meghan con Oprah Winfrey. La palabra que podemos usar para describirla es explosiva. Aquí está Ronder Figueroa para contarnos todos los pormenores de lo que dijeron en esa entrevista, Ronder.
Así es, y alguna gente la está calificando como una entrevista que es como una bomba nuclear, porque esa entrevista amaneció hoy en boca de todos por la impactante confesión de Meghan que estuvo al borde del suicidio. Las acusaciones de racismo en la familia real y el quebrantamiento de la relación entre el príncipe Harry y su hermano William. Aquí está un resumen de la entrevista.
En una explosiva entrevista, Meghan Markle, visiblemente embarazada, le confesó a Oprah Winfrey que la vida real en Londres la dejó al punto de suicidarse.
I just didn't want to be alive anymore. And that was a very clear and real and frightening constant thought. I remember how he just cradled me and I went to the institution and I said that I needed to go somewhere to get help. I said that I've never felt this way before and I need to go somewhere. And I was told that I couldn't, that it wouldn't be good for the institution.
So were you thinking of harming yourself? Were you having suicidal thoughts?
Yes, this was very, very clear.
La pareja compartió un video familiar con su pequeño Archie en una playa de California. Meghan dice que antes de tener al bebé, hubo conversaciones sobre su estatus en la familia real y sobre su raza.
In those months when I was pregnant, all around this same time, so we have in tandem the conversation of he won't be given security, he's not going to be given a title, and also concerns and conversations about how dark his skin might be when he's born.
What? And you're not going to tell me who had the conversation?
I think that would be very damaging to them.
What is particularly striking is what Meghan shared with us earlier, is that no one wants to admit that there's anything about race or that race has played a role in the trolling and the vitriol. What was that conversation?
That conversation I'm never going to share. But at the time, it was awkward. I was a bit shocked.
Can you tell us what the question was?
No, I'm not comfortable sharing that.
Harry y Meghan dicen que la tensión fue al final lo que los hizo alejarse del Reino Unido y de la familia real.
When we were in Canada, I had three conversations with my grandmother and two conversations with my father before he stopped taking my calls. By that point, I took matters into my own hands. It was like, I need to do this for my family.
La pareja dice que la prensa británica también jugó un papel principal en su decisión. La historia sobre cómo Meghan hizo llorar a Kate Middleton fue solo una prueba de las muchas mentiras que Meghan asegura eran historias completamente falsas.
Was there a situation where she might have cried or she could have cried?
No, the reverse happened.
La pareja asegura que se sentían vulnerables y desprotegidos de la monarquía británica.
You said that you love your brother and always will love your brother. You didn't tell me what the relationship is now, though.
The relationship is space at the moment. And, you know, time heals all things, hopefully.